Okay, so you're camping with your friends, and the mosquitoes are driving everyone crazy. You have some bug spray with DEET, and it works really great, but is it safe to spray this chemical all over yourself? Today, studies show that DEET has harmful effects to cells in our bodies.
It can dissolve nylons, it can dissolve plastics, you know, it can destroy your watch band.
This is Anandasankar Ray. He's trying to find safer and more effective ways to repel insects.
Insect repellent that we commonly use, called DEET, has remained unchanged since the 1950s.
This is actually kind of crazy. Bug spray has pretty much stayed the same for 70 years. And when scientists first developed DEET, they didn't really understand why it repelled mosquitoes. And it's hard to improve something when you don't understand how it works. So first, Ray had to figure out how mosquitoes smell.
The mosquito has an incredibly sensitive nose. We emit a substantial amount of carbon dioxide, and this gets carried downwind in the shape of plumes. And the mosquito, when it comes across one such plume, it starts to moving closer and closer towards us and recognizes that, oh, this is a human being that is going to be a source of blood and makes a beeline for us.
And once Ray understood what attracts mosquitoes to people, he turned his attention to repellents. He wanted to understand what chemical features cause this repellency. He looked at a mosquito's nose to see which receptors detect DEET. And then, using this really powerful computer, he took all this data and found some alternatives.
We were able to very rapidly screen nearly 500,000 chemicals in one afternoon and identify 1,000 new substitutes.
100 of these chemicals are already considered safe by the FDA. And unlike DEET, these won't eat through plastic.
These are chemicals that are actually found in fruits, found in plants. Some of these are used in our food for flavoring.
So right now, he's developing a lotion that's as strong as DEET, but uses natural compounds.
We have some that smell like orange blossoms, some that smell like sandalwood.
And really what he's doing here is trying to find scents that we think smell really nice, but mosquitoes don't like. And mosquitoes aren't just annoying when you're camping. They can be quite dangerous. Nearly 1 billion people worldwide are affected by mosquito-borne diseases like Zika, West Nile, dengue, and malaria.
I am hopeful that this approach will lead to interventions that could be useful in the field and perhaps not only help protect us in our backyard barbecues, but also help have an impact on malaria in Africa.
And these same compounds can also repel bed bugs, ants, even insects that destroy the food we grow. So it may not seem important or glamorous to understand just how a mosquito's nose works, but this research has opened up a lot of new possibilities. Are you worried about how different chemicals affect your body? Check out our other video here. And hey, don't forget to click that subscribe button.